So, let's just go ahead and get started. The reaction is really straightforward. What I've got here is I've got the same situation where I've got a double bond, and I've got a diatomic halogen, and I've also got water, let's just say. So I've also got water. Okay? Which of these is going to react with my double bond? Well, water by itself doesn't really do anything to double bonds. Now, if I had water and acid, that would be different, okay? But this is just water by itself, so you can't really react water in a double bond. But we know that we can react a diatomic halogen. So I'm going to draw my three arrows once again, where the X is making a bridge to the double bond, and it's also kicking out one of the X's as a leaving group. What this is going to give me is a bridge ion called a halonium ion once again. And now I just have to figure out what's the nucleophile that's going to do the backside attack or the nucleophilic attack of this ring. Okay? So basically, I've got two nucleophiles. I've got X negative, just like before when we were talking about halogenation. We've got the X negative just like before. Nothing has changed. But now what I also have is I've got some water lying around. Now, of these two different species, which of them do you think is going to be the stronger nucleophile? The X negative or the water? What do you guys think? I've actually asked you guys a question like this before for another mechanism. The answer is that the X negative is going to be much stronger. In fact, X negative is one of the best nucleophiles around. Water is kind of like eh, because X negative has a negative charge. Water is neutral, so we would expect X negative to be a lot stronger. So, why wouldn't I just get the X negative attacking and get a halogenation reaction like before? Well, the answer is that I will. Some of that actually will happen. Some of the X negative will attack and I will get halogenation. But that's not going to be what happens the majority of the time. The majority of the time, this bridged ion is so unstable that it's going to react with the first nucleophile that it encounters, even if it's not the strongest. And what if I have, once again, how about if I have a billion times more? How about if I have a billion times more of the water than I have of the X negative? So what if there's waters everywhere and there's only a few X negatives? Okay? What's going to wind up happening? What's going to wind up happening is that even though the X negative is stronger, the water is just going to have an advantage because there's a lot more of it around. Because when I planned out my reaction, I used a little bit of diatomic halogen and I put a lot of water in there. Okay? So what that means is that in the second step, even though the X negative is more stable and is more nucleophilic, my water is going to wind up attacking the most substituted side. Does that make sense? Because there's just a whole lot more of it around. Now for this water, is it going to attack the more substituted or the less substituted? It's still going to attack the more substituted side because that's the one with the most positive character. And remember, the water has the electrons on it. So I go ahead and I make that bond, I break that bond, and what that's going to give me is a major product that is a halohydrin. So if my water adds to the front, then that means that my X is going to add to the back. Okay? And that means that if my water was in the front, then my methyl group would also be towards the back. Okay? Now, is this my final product? No. I still have one more step, unfortunately, because I added water, so I need to deprotonate, right? I need to get rid of that H. What can I use to get rid of one of those H's? I could use the X negative. So I'm going to use the X negative in this last step to pull off an H and give the electrons to the O. So now what I'm going to get is a product that looks like this. A Markovnikov alcohol and an anti-Markovnikov halogen that's anti. Do we have chiral centers here? Yep, so we have to draw both enantiomers. The other enantiomer would be that the water attacked from the bottom, the methyl is now at the top, and that means that my X is now at the top. And these would be a racemic mixture because I really have no clue which side it came from. Does that make sense, guys? So I hope that you guys were able to see the similarities between halogenation and the halohydrin formation. The only difference is that I've got a lot of water around, so in that second nucleophilic attack, water is going to do the attack instead of the X negative. All right? So let me know if you have any questions on that, but if not, let's go ahead and move on.